Hello. So, first of all, sorry about this general area. I just got out of the bath. The thing I get asked most in the comments of my videos and on Facebook and in my inbox is how I look after my nails and how I get them so long and stuff. And the answer I give everybody is exactly the same, which is I don't do anything special. I've just always had nice nails, which I'm thankful for. But they're never perfect, and I usually cheat with nail varnish, so I'm going to show you from the beginning how I do my nails. And maybe if you spot something I do different to most people, that might be the answer, but I don't think I do anything special. So, you will need, if you're taking off your nail varnish, nail polish remover, obviously. This one is just a pound one, really cheap, with conditioning agents, it says. Vantage nail polish remover has been specifically formulated to contain a conditioning agent for the effective care of your nails. So you'll need that. And some cotton wool. You can use cotton wool balls or I've got these kind of, I don't know, overly things. You also need hands. And nail varnish. Little cotton buds to take off any excess around the edge. Nail scissors. And a nail file. Just an ordinary emery board, if you will. I never use this side because that's the rough side. I always use this side. Okay, so I'll point the camera down a bit and I'll get started. Oops. Okay, so let me just put my dressing gown across so I don't get it everywhere. First thing I do is use my nail polish remover. Oops. And I go backwards and forwards. I don't know if that's special, but probably not. I'm not an expert on keeping nails, I'm just showing you what I do, so if I do anything wrong, sorry. But it's worked all these years, so it should be fine. My nails are a bit stained usually as well because of all the polish I use. Usually a bit discoloured. I change my nail varnish maybe once a week. It usually lasts a long time because I put layers of it on, so try not to chip it and stuff when I'm at work. Try and be extra careful. But there's always moments when you do. And with this, the black crackle that I've got on at the minute, that tends to pull the nail varnish off much easier than ordinary nail varnish. So this one's lasted just a few days. one hand up. When I've been doing my things on my cosplayer blog, it's been difficult because Ray, the character that I use, that I'm cosplaying, is a boy first of all, but he always pushes his glasses up, and I've had like my nail varnish on and stuff, and it's just looked like he's a bit of a weirdo with like pretty nails. I don't think anybody's noticed that much yet, but I've noticed. Usually get away with using just one lot of remover and one cotton thing. Says that she can't do that. Just put a bit more on the back. So all my nail varnish is off now. Let's go on to the next part. Okay, so the next thing is something I only do about every 3 or 4 weeks, which is I actually cut my nails. Now, if you're of a weak disposition, you should probably not watch this bit because it might be traumatizing or something. If you're like really obsessed with nails, I don't know, whatever. The reason I do this is because this one, it's got a weakness where it always snaps really low. I don't know if you can see that. It's like here. So I always cut them all to about this length. That one snapped too. And they grow back long, like really quickly. Now I use scissors with a curl on. They've got a curve, and I just kind of, I know you're gonna be like, no, don't, but don't worry, they grow back and it makes them strong. And I try to shape them as much as possible with the scissors. And then I go back and file them. So it's still long. It's like, that one's all right actually. And I will hoover up afterwards. Show you how I file. I never file like that. I always come from the outside into the middle. That's something my gran taught me. She said that it'll split your nails if you go like back and forward. So I always just go from the outside to the middle. I've heard various things that you can do with your nails to keep them healthy, like soak them in olive oil and things, like some crazy things like that. I've never done anything like that. I've never had a proper manicure at like a salon or anything like that. I know some people really don't like the sound of nail files as well, so I apologise for that. You can just skip this bit if you want and go to me painting them. I always round them off as well. I never have square nails. So I just can't bear the feel of them when they're on a surface and it's like a square. Oh, it freaks me out. I don't know why. And I never use metal nail files, I always just use these ones. I just find the metal ones too, like, rough. I'm not filing bloody stainless steel, you know, it's just my nails. There's that hand to it. Looks much neater. Now this one, but my left hand's really hard to control. I find it quite useless at times, so it's usually it's hard to cut with it. So I usually end up just tearing them off like that, and it's really bad. Oh, it's also easier to cut and file your nails if you've just had a bath, or if you've like soaked them in warm water for a little bit. It just makes them a bit softer, so they're a bit more malleable. Malleable, is that the word? Excellent. And there's loads of links online that say like how to temporarily fix like nails that have snapped and stuff, bits of gauze and stuff. I've never tried it. Obviously, if you've got really short nails, you shouldn't cut them as much if you want them to grow long. It's not like, you know how people say, like, get your hair cut and it'll grow healthier or whatever. Well, if you get your nails cut, they're just going to take longer to grow. So yeah. You probably don't want to do that. That one's gone all torn up a bit. Yeah. See, they split just like everybody else. I think one of the reasons my nails always look really long, even when they're not, is because my actual nail beds are really long and I've got like long skinny fingers, so I think they always look longer than they actually are anyway. is the last one. I'm almost done. Yeah, so that one's really short now. Bless it. But when I get a nail varnish on, it'll look fine. So that's them, they're all neat. Next thing. Base coat. I would recommend a base coat. Not only does it kind of smooth out your ridges on your nails, it also, sorry, let me zoom in a bit. It also, stops them being stained as much. Really? Okay, let me just try and get the lid off. So I get quite a bit on the brush, and from the middle, and then each side. If you can, try to do it in 3 strokes only. So you need quite a bit on your brush. I have the skinniest little finger ever, so that just takes 1 stroke. It's really pathetic. So that's that base coat. I only ever put 1 base coat on as well, because the more layers of nail varnish you put on, the more kind of squidgy they go. So they're more likely to get chipped or like smudged. Even like the next day, they can still be squidgy. This one that I'm using is called Nina Ultra Pro Salon Formula Nail Lacquer, and it's number 709287. It says base coat / ridge filler. That's that. I'll just let that dry for a minute. This is the professional waft until the dry technique. Yes, I can show you. I'm doing flowers on them today. I thought I'd be quite girly. I'll show you some pictures that I saw that were really pretty. I thought they were really nice. And then ones. So I think I'm going to do these ones, but not exactly the same, because I won't be as good as that, but kind of based around that. Okay, so I'm going to use this as the bottom coat, which is Nail Paint by Barry M. Number 304, Mint Green. Barry M nail varnish is always really nice. The only thing that annoys me is that the brushes are dead skinny, so you've got to go for a while to get your nail covered. Somebody needs to like rejig them with thicker brushes. I've been trying to figure out a way of how to hook up my Blue Yeti microphone to my camcorder, but every time I've used my Blue Yeti it's just been recording with my webcam software, and then I'm having to like sync up the audio from that and then the visual from this. So I'm trying to think of a way of how I can attach the Blue Yeti to my actual camcorder, but so far I've had no joy. So if anybody has any advice, please let me know. Because for my last roleplay that I did, my cosplay roleplay, I'd actually recorded the audio with my Blue Yeti. And it was all 3D and nice, but it like ended up being really weird in the middle, and it like skipped some frames, and my voice was like out of sync with my face and stuff. So that was really annoying. So yeah, it's just a JVC camcorder. It's not a dead expensive one, it's just a cheap HD one. Nothing special about it really. It says 40 times optical zoom. So I'll leave that to dry a bit. And then when it's not tacky anymore, I'll put another coat on, because I like to have it so that you can't see the actual colour of my finger through. And now's the point where I get a really itchy back for some reason, which I can't itch. That's so annoying. While you're waiting, do you want to see some of the jewellery I've been making for my Etsy shop? I've made two of these, which are eventually going to be dangly earrings, and they're going to be painted as pokeballs. And I've also made this little chap. He's just a head, but he's going to have a face and have cool looking hair and stuff, just for a key ring. And I've also made this dolphin, which is going to be for a key ring. It's going to be painted and stuff. So yeah, I thought I'd do some key rings so that like guys can enjoy my shop as well as girls. And I've bought some false nails, and I've painted them, and I'm going to be selling like sets of 10 of those on my shop as well. So yeah, you can have the designs that I put on my nails on your nails, but without all the faff, so you just stick the false nail on, which I thought was quite a good idea. when I'm doing them, I try to get as much of the excess nail varnish like off my fingers while it's still wet. So it's much easier than when it starts to dry. K-pop stuck in my head. Try not to hum it because that won't be very relaxing. That hand done. A tip I once read in a magazine is that you're supposed to paint over the edge of each nail and that stops it chipping. I've never done it, but apparently that's meant to work, so try that if you like. It's always a side that I can't see. And this is the really short one, this ring finger. But as you can see, when it's got nail varnish on it, it pretty much looks the same as the others. Can you tell I'm not breathing when I do it? I hold my breath every time. Okay, let's zoom out a bit. Oops, that's in. So that's the base coat done. Just wait for that to dry. For the next bit, I'm going to be using these, which are my nail art pens. It says professional nail art pen and brush by Rio. They're dead good actually. If you just pull the top, it's got the pen. And if you twist them off, oh, it's hard, I don't want to spoil my nail. There we go. If you twist it off, it's like a big, bendy brush. I find the pen bit easier to control, so I'm going to use that. I'm going to do like a few flowers on each finger. And just like a blob, and then some white bits to highlight them, and some green for their leaves. I will do red and blue on each finger, I think. But I've got to wait till this dries almost completely first. Wow, this is a long video. Sorry, I'm in my pyjamas as well, and they don't even match. an apple here, look. Shall we recreate the Twilight cover? There you go. And no, I'm not going to dig my nails in it because I don't think they'd be that strong. I think they might actually snap if I did that. And the nail varnish would definitely smudge. What else has an apple? Oh, Snow White. Take the apple, dear. I'm sorry. I'm just playing. Oh, it's gonna fall. Oh no, there's my feet. Okay. I'm gonna use this. Zoom in a little bit. Well, and I'm gonna do. Let me just make sure it's coming out. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna do some blobs. Ooh. Sorry, my back's itching. Okay. Now my left hand is useless for everything but putting nail varnish on my right. I don't know why it can do it. I mean, it's never as good as the other hand, but it still does it somehow, and I don't know how. It's like a miracle of life. To make my eyes water. Inhaling it. Now this will take a bit longer to dry because it's a bit thicker. Can you see I was like splodging on? This is where your hands become totally useless. So I'll wait for that to dry a little bit. so they're not quite dry but new enough. So I'll do some of the dark green as leaves. Hell. Again, using this pen bit, just make sure it's coming out. Okay, yep. By the end, I'm usually covered in nail varnish, so yeah. I'm just gonna go on the flowers, well, next to the flowers, in like a line, kind of a goopy line. So I'm making it thicker where the flower is and then thinner away from it. It's making me shake. Oh good lord, it's coming out the bottle.
Oh hell no.
Okay, let me just
get that off my hand.
Is there any need? Crisis averted. Let's carry on. Whoa, that one's gone a bit mad. I watched a film today that was pretty good. Got it on my duvet, but never mind. Film today, yes. It was called, I can't remember what it was called, but it was that one where the, it's got the famous line where he says, "I'm going out, I may be away sometime." It was about them guys trekking to the North Pole or South Pole. I'm not sure. Sorry, I don't have much information on it. but yeah, it was really good. It's like a really old one. But it was pretty sad as well. It's like, oh no. They all like, they didn't get there first and they all died, and it was like, God, what is the point? Can you even see what I'm doing? I told you I had K-pop stuck in my head. It's 2:21. I'll keep falling in love, falling in love. got to be careful of your other fingers not smudging them on the same hand, because my fingers have lives of their own.
That bit's done.
So that's those done. And then I'll add some white to them and then they'll be done. Finished. Almost. So I'll just wait for them to dry and then put the white bits on. Okay, so I'm going to go into the final bit, which is putting the white on. I'm going to try. See if I can use the brush on this bit, because it's thinner than the pen.
The brush is thinner than the pen. No, that's not really good.
Oh my god.
Okay.
Sneeze.
Sorry.
Do I need to zoom in again? Bloody hell. Okay. So I'm just gonna add a few tiny white. Try not to totally destroy them. Sorry, I can't really show you this bit because I have to concentrate. I'm really close. too shabby. It's making me want to sneeze all the time. This is where the left hand is just for decoration. Half of this isn't even in shot, you know. I can't tell because I'm concentrating so much. There we have it. Finished product. Now, if I were you, I would put a layer of clear over this. But not yet, because it'll just go bleh and smudge. But I usually end up not doing it because it makes it quite gooey. So it's up to you, really. If you've got quite a thin one that dries really fast, then that'd be really good. But the one I've got is LP. And it's not that good really, it kind of smudges a lot. So I'm just going to leave them like that. So let me put you back up. Hello. Thanks so much for watching. That's my nails. Ooh, I don't want it to focus on. More videos coming soon. There's another clue to my treasure hunt down the bottom of this video. Yeah, I'll see you guys soon. Bye!